The training techniques are tried and true.
You're gonna beam raise it, right? Just like we showed you last night.
The trainers have spent decades putting these tasks to the test in real life emergencies. But most of these trainees are not only new to the fire service, they're first-time residents of the city of Thibodaux as college students at Nicholls State University. They're also part of a new and innovative recruiting initiative by the Thibodaux Volunteer Fire Department in collaboration with the university, the Student Firefighter Association.
The form an organization on campus kind of targets our demographic of new recruits. A lot of people who travel in this area or come into Nicholls State don't realize that we are 100% volunteer fire department. So we kind of educate them on that, and it kind of helps them to have another avenue inside of the campus. Besides a fraternity or sorority, this is another avenue that some of them choose to take, and they can also benefit the community and the campus.
Those benefits include adding to the headcount of the fire department as fully committed members, with their response and fire prevention efforts mainly focused on campus buildings and population. In addition, SFA members provide medical assistance and crowd control for large events and even participate in philanthropic efforts like raising money for AEDs to go in all campus buildings.
Kind of like we have a rescue squad, a communication squad, a hose tender, and things of that effect. Well, SFA is kind of another group of our department, but they get together to do stuff just on Nicholls campus also.
I guess it started as a club, but now it's basically a firefighting unit. They take these individuals and they train with them. They volunteer in the Thibodaux Volunteer Fire Department, and they respond to fires and emergencies both on the campus and in the surrounding areas. I think it's a phenomenal program.
The 2019-2020 school year is the second for the SFA, with hopes of building on a very successful start.
It's hopefully to have an influx of members, because some of them, fortunately, you only have them for 4 years. If they're not from this area, they go back home. We have several in the organization that are from Texas. We have a few that live in Houma. We've had some that applied from New Orleans. So they come here, they'll spend their 4 years while they're staying on campus here, and they're staying in the dorms here. They respond to this community and on campus. But you're right, once they do get home, they'll have that knowledge to volunteer. And most of them that come through will volunteer when they get back or wherever they go to or whatever industry they go into. Some of them go work at the plants. Well, they end up on the fire brigade or the hazmat team because of stuff they've learned here throughout their college.
The personal benefits for association members are extensive, too.
Being a volunteer organization, we have all personnel from lawyers, doctors, people who work in the plants. Myself, I'm a computer guy. So whatever field they're going into, I can pair them. You need to talk to so-and-so. You know, they can help you out in your career path. And that goes a long ways also.
As appreciative as the department is to have this much interest from such a young audience, the association members are equally as grateful for this unique opportunity to invest in their futures.
We got all these young college students looking to do something for themselves, for the community, for them, for their families. I mean, letting the fire departments and the colleges join together to make clubs like this is amazing, knowing that they've linked together to take students in, make them better themselves.
Camille Hart, who bought in after visiting the association's booth at orientation last year, will take her skills from here to a fire company in Scotland while she's there attending vet school.
I heard that it was a great program, and I've always had this want to help people, and I think that it's not really a female job. Most females don't really think about it, so I really wanted to prove that we could do it and also help people in the process, and it's been so much fun.
Austin Montero is still as passionate about serving his community as he was when he joined the department in high school.
I recommend this to anyone. I think it's a tremendous organization, you know, tremendous fire department that could, you know, you could make a difference in people's lives. And, you know, that in the end, that feels good on your end, you know that you're helping people.
The Thibodaux Volunteer Fire Department has always stood out as a unique operation across the state, with manpower in the hundreds and a lucrative annual firefighter fair to support its budget. So it's no surprise they're now leading the effort in creating ways to breathe new life into volunteerism in the fire service.
Everything that they have built has really been, on the blood, sweat, and hands of community volunteers who want to have the best fire protection they can have. And, you know, for a city of, 30,000 or so, it's pretty impressive that that's the number one priority in the city.
State Fire Marshal Butch Browning hopes the SFA concept can be an inspiration to other departments.
This is a great program, and we certainly are trying to highlight it and get interest across the state where there are other state colleges and universities to do this.
The Thibodaux Fire Department is just hoping to inspire young people to do more for their communities.
Become something great. It's more than fighting fires. Get involved.